Colorado residents are starting to notice that orange sludge settling into the sediment and along the banks of the Animas River. But today, the Utah Attorney General made it clear just because we didn't see that sludge in Utah waters doesn't mean our state leaders are less vigilant about river cleanup.
When news of toxic mine sludge spilled into southeastern communities, Utahns realized it was going to take a toll.
Our whole marketing is a pristine area that you can really find a pristine landscape, pristine water, pristine land, pristine, yeah, that's our whole thing.
People we spoke to say this spill will taint public perception of the San Juan River for years to come, and residents want the EPA to know that.
They should be held responsible and be answerable to the people, you know, and be held accountable.
The Utah Attorney General Sean Reyes wants people to understand he hears them and feels the same way. Reyes flew to Durango and met with AGs from Colorado and New Mexico to talk about the effects of the spill.
Well, Utah needs a voice. You know, I think Colorado and New Mexico have received the lion's share of attention because they were ground zero, and Utah's further downstream, but our citizens are just as important.
Reyes says the attorneys general will work together to evaluate short and long-term damage. He says the communication with the EPA on the toxic sludge has not been easy for state leaders either.
But it is frustrating that the administrator is here, 2 minutes away, just had a press conference, saying, I'm here to meet with stakeholders, including governors and local officials, and we've had our requests as three attorneys general for impacted states. So far not granted, but you know, we'll see.
In the meantime, Reyes says he's going to fight for Utah, fight for river cleanup, and hold the EPA accountable.
Litigation is not off the table, and litigation is a very general word. It can encompass a number of different things and avenues. We are waiting for data. I mean, we're waiting to see what the long-term effects are over weeks, months, and years.
And when the plume of mining sludge moved through this area, the pH of the water drastically changed. I touched base with DEQ field crews today in southeastern Utah. They tell me the pH of that water today was the same as the last several days. It has not varied. Reporting in Durango, Colorado, Alana Brophy, Good for Utah.